हर 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 डियर स्टूडेंट्स, जय हिंद एंड वेरी गुड मॉर्निंग। वेलकम बैक टू आवर ई लर्निंग सेशन। एज यू ऑल नो, इन आवर प्रीवियस लेक्चर नंबर 11, in the particular chapter of 10, that is mensuration, we had completed our discussion regarding area and volume of cube and cuboid. Now today, in the same chapter, we are targeting the last topic in this particular chapter, and that topic deals with area and volume of right cylinder. Okay, so today, Chapter 10, as you know, my dear student, today you are attending the last lecture in this particular chapter. Today you are going to attend lecture number 12, okay, the last one in this particular chapter, where we are going to discuss about surface area and volume of cylinder. Okay, that's our topic of discussion today. As my dear student, you know, every time when we think of any cylinder, what is we are doing? We are always trying to derive formulas. Understand? Because I insist you to derive the formula, the target is you can remember formula for particular solid for a long period of time. Okay, before I start discussion about the last topic, let me make the title here. The topic today is surface area, understood, and volume of surface area and volume of cylinder. That's the topic we are going to target today. Okay, now my dear student, before we move into this particular topic, I want you to have at least idea of some of the formulas. Two formulas of circle, that is what I want you to first regenerate in your mind. Okay, the first one I am writing here, suppose my dear student, suppose this is a circle, okay? Suppose this is a circle having radius r, okay? So I want you to remember two formulas regarding circle 1, these formulas are going to be very very useful when you deal with cylinder. Okay, first formula, that is regarding, my dear student, boundary of the circle, this one, which we call circumference. You understood? Circumference. You have to remind this formula in your mind. Circumference, that is 2πr. You have to remember this formula because they are going to be quite useful to us. Understand? And one another formula, my dear student, that's regarding area of circle. Okay, what is that? Even if you don't know the formula, please try to remember pi r square. These two formulas are going to be quite useful to us in deriving the formulas of surface area and volume of a cylinder. Understood? See, my dear student, I do not want you to try to no doubt you have to understand and remember the formula that you all know, but I do not want you to just mug up the formula. Actually, I want you to understand how the particular formula is derived. That is very important. Okay, see, my dear student, first let me show you the shape of the cylinder. This is cylinder I am showing here. Okay, now in this cylinder, this is called top. This is called bottom. Bottom, or sometime you can say base. Top and bottom both are circular in shape. That's why I have given you idea regarding the circle, because base is also circular, top is also circular. Understand? This is called lateral surface. Okay, today first we are trying to understand how to derive the formula for lateral surface area of cylinder. Just try to understand, my dear student. Formula is directly available. That is, lateral surface area equals to 2 pi rh, directly available. But you need to really understand how the formula actually came. See, my dear student, I am just trying to explain you how this is. We are talking of hollow cylinder, nothing inside, not solid cylinder. Try to understand. Understood? Suppose, my dear student, let me draw one rectangular sheet of paper. Okay, why I am explaining to you this? Because it might be very useful in solving some difficult example. Suppose, my dear student, we have a rectangular sheet of paper, okay? This is length and this is breadth, okay? If I ask you, what is the area of this rectangular strip of paper, you will immediately answer length into breadth, okay? Now, my dear student, try to understand. This rectangular strip of paper, this, if I just handle this two edge and I make it this way, it becomes cylinder. You understood this? Understood? Rectangle, understood? Suppose this is rectangular sheet as it is here. This is length, this is breadth. If you just do this way, it becomes a cylinder. You understood this? So, my dear student, try to just understand the moment I roll down this sheet along the length. So, what happens? This length actually becomes the circumference either of top or either of base. You understood this? This length is rolled down into circle. So, L becomes circumference of top or circumference of base. So, I can say L equal to 2 pi r. You understood this? And B becomes the height of the cylinder. You understood this? Now, if you now find area of this rectangular sheet of paper L into B, you replace L by 2 pi r and replace B by h, what it becomes? 2 pi r h. The lateral surface area. You got my point? How to find lateral surface area? No doubt. You just have to remember the formula, that is sufficient for you. But at least how the lateral surface area turns out to be 2 pi rh, that must has to click in your mind. That is very important. Understand? L becomes 2 pi r, B becomes h when you roll down, and this became 2 pi rh, that is the lateral surface area. Sheet of paper now became the circular surface, lateral surface area. Okay, dear students, so first formula for the cylinder, let me write lateral surface area. What should I write? L into B means I will write 2 pi r into h, that becomes 2 pi r h. The first formula, that is lateral surface area 2 pi r h. Okay? Is it clear in your mind? Right. Second formula. There can be, my dear student, two types of cylinder, one open cylinder, one closed cylinder. Okay. Now what happened? When the cylinder is open, there would not be top, only bottom. Like we have barrel at home, understand, for filling water, they are with bottom, not top, so they can be considered open cylinder. So now, my dear student, if this statement comes, what is that? Total surface area of, if it is written open cylinder, some of the words you need to catch in your mind. If it is written total surface area of open cylinder means what, my dear student? It will include lateral surface plus bottom. What is the area of base? I already declared pi r square, so I will write 2 pi rh. 2 pi rh, because that's the lateral surface, it is going to come, plus area of base, that is area of bottom, understood? So I, area of base, what should I write? Pi r square, you understood? Let me take out the common. What is common? Pi r is common. What is left here? 2h. From pi r square, pi r is taken out as common. What is left? R. So this is the second formula, dear student. That is total surface area of open cylinder. I am always insisting the student that never just mug up the formula. No doubt, when you solve any example, definitely you have to remember the formula, because that's not the time in the test while solving example that you try to derive the formula. That is not going to happen in exam. But by chance, if you forgot the formula of, take an example, total surface area of open cylinder, if your mind is set and if your basics are clear, you know 2 pi rh plus pi r square, take out common, pi r into bracket 2h plus r. That's why I insist that every student should know how to derive the formula. That is very, very important for you. You understood this, okay? Now, suppose, my dear student, you have a cylinder which is a closed cylinder. That means, closed cylinder means having bottom and top both. It is closed from the top. So there will be two area. One is area of base, pi r square, area of top, pi r square means twice pi r square. So, my dear student, what is the next formula? I am writing it here, okay? You just write with me. Total surface area of closed cylinder, that's important word, closed cylinder, and the meaning has to be very clear in your mind. Closed cylinder means having top as well as bottom. Okay, so what, how can we derive its formula? First you will write 2 pi rh, lateral surface area is going to be there, and one area of base, one area of top, because it is closed cylinder, so I can write twice time pi r square. Okay, one for base, one for top. Let us take out common 2 pi r, h plus r is left. So this is formula for total surface area of closed cylinder. This word needs to click in your mind. Open cylinder and closed cylinder. Open means not having top. Closed means having top as well as bottom. Okay. And the last formula which we want to derive, actually that formula you just have to remember. Okay, that is called volume of cylinder. Okay, that you need to just remember, pi r square h. That's the another formula, pi r square h. So my dear student, as far as cylinder is concerned, hollow cylinder we are talking, you need to remember these four formulas. One regarding lateral surface area, that's 2 pi rh. One regarding total surface area of open cylinder, pi r into bracket 2h plus r. Then total surface area of closed cylinder, 2 pi r into bracket h plus r. And then volume of cylinder, that's pi r square h. This many formula you have to remember for solving various examples regarding cylinder. Okay, as far as these formulas are concerned, understand, and the topic regarding cylinder is concerned, right, we are going to solve at least around 10 examples of different type, so that the topic becomes extremely clear in your mind. Okay, that's our target today. Okay, my dear student, I think you have written everything, right? Let us then go for solving different types of examples. Okay, let us solve some different types of example. First we'll start with some simple examples. Okay, and then we'll move for difficult examples also, right? Today, one thing also we are going to do, dear student, is that whenever we are trying to solve any particular example today, it may happen that I will just speak out the sum, but I am not going to write the whole example here. I may just write the basic information that is regarding the dimensions and as far as the examples of cylinder are concerned, the basic two dimension will always be given to you, that is radius of the base and height. That is the two data you require, two measurement you require for solving any particular example. Okay, suppose let us start solving some example, my dear student. First one, suppose we take, okay, let me write here. See, my dear student, I am writing the sum in this way for cylinder. You also write in the same way for cylinder. Okay, for cylinder, radius equal to 7 centimeter, height equal to 10 centimeters. Suppose you are given radius and height. See, I have written the sum for cylinder. Radius has been given, that is 7 centimeter. Height has been given 10 centimeter. Now, my dear student, we are trying to find all four dimensions. That means we are trying to find lateral surface area, total surface area considering it one time open cylinder, one time closed cylinder because it is not mentioned, and then we will also find volume of the same cylinder. Okay, all four parameters we are targeting to find. Okay, so my dear student, radius and height is given, the first part of the sum. Let me designate R equal to 7 centimeter, height H equal to 10 centimeter. First, dear student, we are going to find lateral surface area. Okay, let me write the formula. Lateral surface area equals to, what is the formula you all know very well? That's 2 pi RH. Value of pi has been mentioned in the sum that you all know, 22/7. Let us substitute the values. 2 into, what is the value of pi given? 22/7. What is the radius? We have 7. Height we have 10. Just cancel this. This turns out to be 22 × 40 × 10 = 440 square centimeter. 440 square centimeter. So we found lateral surface area. Okay, now dear student, let us try to find total surface area, okay, if open cylinder, because it hasn't been mentioned, that's why. You know the formula. What is that? Pi r 2h plus r. You know the formula? Total surface area if open cylinder. Understood? Let us substitute the values. Pi, that is 22 upon 7. Do the sum with me. What is the value of r? That is 7. No sign here means multiply. In bracket 2h. 2 as it is. See, what is height? That is 10. Plus r, that is 7. You understood this? This is going to be 22 upon 7 into 7. Okay, can we place it directly? You understood this? 2 10 ja 20. 20 plus 7, that is 27. Let me write 27 here. This is cancelled already. Now you just have to multiply 27, 22 ja, okay. And my dear student, you got the answer 594 square centimeter, okay. So this is total surface area. If, because it hasn't been mentioned in the example, that's why only we have to worry about whether it is open cylinder or closed cylinder. Okay. We have considered in finding the second topic, understand as it is an open cylinder, that we accepted. Okay. Now the third one, let us move for it. Third, that's total surface area of closed cylinder. Now we are thinking it as a closed cylinder. Okay, dear student, two options. First, we considered it as an open cylinder. Now we are considering it as a closed cylinder. Okay. Let us write the formula 2 pi r h plus r. Let us substitute the values 2 into. What is the value of pi? 22 upon 7. What is radius? 7 into h, that is 10, r, that is 7, okay. 2 into 22 upon 7 into 7 into 10 plus 7, that is 17. This is cancelled. Now it's simple. 22 to the 44 into 17. Just do it. Okay. So this turns out to be 748. Understood? 748 square centimeter. Is it clear in your mind? Right? Then we will move for the another one, that is the last, that is volume of cylinder, let me write volume of cylinder, okay? You all know the formula, that is volume of cylinder pi r square h. Let us substitute the values pi 22 upon 7. Okay, because here is r square, I will write r twice. That you should always do. Don't write 7 square and 49. Don't do like that. R square, write 7 into 7. What is the height? That's 10. 1 is cancelled here. 22, 7 ja, 154, 10 ja, 1540 cubic centimeter. So, dear student, you can look at the sum we have derived. All that is required, okay? We have derived lateral surface area, then we derived total surface area considering it an open cylinder, then we derived total surface area considering it as a closed cylinder, then we derived the formula for volume of a cylinder, okay? Four parameters we were looking for and we have found out, okay? Now, my dear student, let us try to solve one another basic example, okay, of the same type, and then we may move for some difficult type of examples, okay? Let us try to understand one example. This is clear in your mind. Whenever you are given radius and height, it becomes easy for you to solve any particular example. Understood? Let us move for one another example. Today, example number 2. What type of example is this? Let us first try to understand it, okay? What type of data has been given in the sum? And then we have to understand the sum, okay? See, my dear student, suppose you are given the data like this, okay? We are solving second example today. For cylinder, just write with me, for cylinder, two data has been given, understand, in this solving this particular example. See, my dear student, what is the data given, okay? You are given, let me write here, you are given the volume. Volume has been given to you. What is the volume given to you? 6160 square centimeter. The volume of the cylinder has been given, and you are given at the same time also height of the cylinder, okay? Height of the cylinder is also given 40 centimeter. These two data has been given in this particular example. Value of pi otherwise not mentioned, we will always take 22/7, that you all know very well. We are given volume of the cylinder and we are given height of the cylinder. What is left to find? Radius of the base, that we have to find. It has been written in the sum that the volume of a cylinder having height 40 centimeter is 6160 cubic centimeter. Find radius of the base of a cylinder. Okay. So, dear student, just concentrate when I solve this example. What is given, tell me. You are given volume of cylinder, that is 6160 cubic centimeter. You are given the volume. At the same time, you are also given height of the cylinder. What is that? 40 centimeter. What you are looking for, my dear student? Radius of the base. Okay? Here in such type of example, I want your much alertness and attention, because when you are given radius and height and you find all data like lateral surface, total surface, volume, it's a simple way of just substituting the value and getting the answer. But here, my dear student, you have to apply the formula and substitution in a proper way. Okay, volume is given, let us write. You have to write this way. Volume of cylinder. Dear student, what is the formula of volume of cylinder? Pi r square h. Volume has been given to us. Try to understand, dear student. Volume is given. What is that? 6160 cubic centimeter. That I will write here. 6160 equal to, what is the value of pi? 22/7. R, our target. H, that is 40, given already. You understood the first step. Volume of cylinder, that's pi r square h. 6160 equal to value of pi, that's 22/7 into r square, understood, into h. H, height has been given to us. Now, my dear student, the next step is very important. That is transferring all the term on this side except r square. This is important. 7 in denominator will cross multiply here, 22 and 40 in numerator will be brought down here as denominator. You understood this? Okay, let me do that step. 6160, because here is equal to sign 7 cross multiply into 7 upon this 2 numeral will come here down, 22 into 40 equals to r square. Okay, this is important for you to particularly understand. No mistakes should happen here while substituting the values and transferring the rest of the data on this side. Denominator will cross multiply, data in the numerator has to be brought down here as denominator. First you understand this step particularly, because I have seen student making lots of mistake just in substituting the values and transferring the terms, and that's why I am taking time to make your mind clear, because volume is given, because height is given. First we wrote the formula of volume of cylinder. In place of volume of cylinder we wrote 6160, 22 upon 7 into r square into 40. Then it's a question of transferring the term. Understand? Be very sure regarding this. Denominator becomes numerator, numerator becomes denominator when the term are transferred. Okay, now it's a question. Let me write it, repeat here so that you can make it more clear. 6160, I am just writing, you don't write repeat. Understood? We have limits of boards, that's why r square. Okay, this zero has been cancelled. Understood? Am I able to cancel 616 by 4? Yes, definitely. 415 = 60, 1 left, 154. This is 22, 7 ja. So my dear student, what is left now? This is 7, 7 ja, 49 equal to r square. Just take out the square root, 7 equal to r. You got the answer. That's how you can get radius of the base of a cylinder. Okay, when you get this particular answer right, you have to at the end write the statement of the sum. This is very important, understand? And if you don't write the final statement, it may result that you will lose the sum mark. The radius of base, okay, of cylinder, this is the way you need to write, is 7 cm. This is the way you have to write, and this is the way you can solve any example given to you. Is it clear in your mind what type of sum it is? Volume was given, understood, and height was given and you are looking for the radius. Suppose you are asked in the example, find diameter of the base of the cylinder. Obviously, my dear student, your first target is to find radius. Diameter, you all know, that's basic. I expect from the student, that has to be clear. D equal to 2R. Diameter is always double than the radius. So you can take the double of the radius, you will get 14. That becomes the diameter. Is it clear in your mind? So dear student, what I want you to be very sure is, once you know the data given, once you know the proper formula to be applied, you have to be very, very sure regarding how to apply particular formula, how to substitute the values, how to transfer the value, means how to make the required parameter as subject. Rest of the number are transferred on this side. Understand? I have seen lots of mistake are happening by the student in transferring the terms. And even I have seen student, suppose I told you here, just 7 will cross multiply. I have seen student directly multiplying, not writing this way. That is also, I must make it clear. Be little more smarter than only the hard worker. Do not multiply. Even I haven't multiplied 22 into 40. I have kept them as it is, and I transferred them in denominator, because I know very well that when brought term in denominator, they are going to help me in simple cancellation. If you would have multiplied this and then transferred, ultimately it becomes little more difficult for you to do the cancellation process. So, as far as this part of the chapter is concerned, be very sure, never multiply unnecessarily any number given, because they are going to get cancelled in the last phase of the sum. Okay? So, my dear student, today we have solved, understand, some basic examples regarding area and volume of the cylinder. We are definitely going to practice some more difficult examples, which are actually application of the same formula but little twisted examples, which ultimately demand some stimulation of mind. Understand? So that we will solve in our next lecture. Okay, dear student, thank you very much for attending today's lecture from Bharat Sir.